Into the retroperitoneum, CT evaluation of renal tumors. Introduction: detection of malignant renal masses and their differentiation from their benign counterparts is extremely important, especially when these masses are small. Despite recent advances, most renal adenocarcinomas are relatively unresponsive to chemotherapy and radiation therapy. Surgery of low-stage lesions remains the only hope for long-term survival and cure. CT is the most sensitive imaging modality for detection of renal masses. Objectives of the study: detection and characterization of renal masses which are considered indeterminate or malignant on ultrasonography. Materials and methods: study was done on patients with suspicion of renal tumors who were referred to the Department of Radiodiagnosis. Patients were evaluated through the computed tomography using G-Revolution 32 slice scanner. It was obtained with a single breath hold time from the level of diaphragm to the level of iliac crest. Results: in our study, total 50 cases were taken, 32 were males, 18 were females, 43 were malignant cases, and 7 were benign cases. Out of which, renal cell carcinoma was the majority, which included 21 cases, accounted for 62% of all renal masses and 72% of malignant renal masses. Transitional carcinoma were 2 in number, Willems tumor 7, metastasis 3, cysts 3, abscesses 2, multilocular cystic nephroma 1, oncocytoma 1. Coming to discussion, this is the normal, different phases of normal renal contrast enhancement on MDCT. This is a non-contrast enhancement. This is the corticomedullary phase enhancement. This is the nephrogenic phase enhancement. And this is the excretory phase enhancement. Coming to renal cysts, it is the most common renal mass in the adult, and simple renal cysts arise from the cortex. Simple cyst may become complicated as a result of hemorrhage, infection, or other processes that thicken some or the entire wall and may increase the attenuation of the contents. According to Bosniak, it has been classified into 4 types: Bosniak type 1, 2, 3, 4. Type 1 is uniform low attenuation and non-enhancing wall. Type 2 is cyst with uniform high attenuation and no enhancement. Type 3 is cyst with thin enhancing septations. Type 4 is cyst with definite solid enhancing component. Coming to renal cell carcinoma, pathologically adenocarcinoma, it is the most common primary renal malignancy in adults, occur most commonly in males. It is sporadic but can be associated with von Hippel-Lindau syndrome. The risk factors include tobacco smoking, exposure to petroleum products, or asbestos. RCC is the most common, most commonly an incidentally detected renal mass, but it may present with symptoms such as pain, hematuria, weight loss, or abdominal distension. Histologically, it is divided into 6 types: clear cell type, which is the most common type, multilocular type, papillary type, chromophobe type, collecting duct, and renal medullary type. Drops and staging of renal carcinoma include stage 1, which is confined to kidney; stage 2, involvement of perinephric fat and limited to xerotic fascia; stage 3A, renal vein involvement; 3B, nodal involvement; 3C, both renal vein and nodal involvement. Stage 4 is further divided into 4A with direct invasion of adjacent structures; 4B is distant metastasis. This is renal cell carcinoma. NACT shows a soft tissue exophytic mass in the left kidney. Lesion shows enhancement on contrast administration. This is another case which shows areas of calcification in a renal cell carcinoma case. This is a case of stage 3 renal cell carcinoma. NACT shows soft tissue mass in the right kidney with pockets of air in the posterior perineal space. The lesion shows enhancement and infiltration into the second part of duodenum and the right psoas muscle. This is a stage 4 renal cell carcinoma with hypervascular metastasis in the right lobe of liver, and renal cell carcinoma with a cannon-borne primary metastasis, pulmonary metastasis. Transitional carcinoma. Transitional carcinoma is the second most common renal neoplasm. It is seen in urinary bladder, followed by ureter and renal pelvis. Risk factors include NSAID abuse, tobacco use, and occupational exposure. Patients present with hematuria, pain, and weight loss. Most common CT appearances: it is a small hypodense lesion, and the amount of enhancement is less than that of surrounding renal parenchyma. Therefore, it appears hypodense compared to the kidney. It is an enhancing soft tissue mass filling the entire right pelvic cell system, causing proximal hydronephrosis. Coming to Willems tumor, it is the most common primary malignant tumor of the childhood, renal tumor of the childhood. It is seen in children aged 3 to 4 years. In some cases, it is associated with WAGR syndrome, DRASH syndrome, or Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome. They present most frequently with palpable abdominal mass, less often with abdominal pain or gross hematuria. Approximately 10% of metastatic disease at the presentation. Metastases are characteristically to the lungs, less frequently to the liver. This is a case of Wilms tumor. Unenhanced CT scan shows a heterogeneous soft tissue mass almost replacing the right kidney with the discrete areas of calcification noted within. This is another case of Wilms tumor, stage 3, which shows involvement of IVC as a non-enhancing filling defect and invasion of renal vein. Metastasis. Renal metastases are present in approximately 10 to 20% of patients. The most common primary are lung, colon, breast carcinoma, melanoma, and reproductive organ malignancies such as testicular or ovarian carcinoma. This is a case of bilateral renal metastasis. CCT shows bilateral renal metastasis from colonic carcinoma, which did not show any enhancement. This is a case of lung carcinoma metastasis to the left kidney, which shows a unifocal soft tissue density lesion, which shows heterogeneous enhancement. Renal oncocytoma is a benign tumor. It appears as a solid enhancing mass with characteristics like those of RCC. In fact, the appearance of typical renal oncocytoma cannot be differentiated from RCC. It is more common in men. They are asymptomatic but presents with hematuria, pain, or mass. This is a case of renal oncocytoma. NECT shows soft tissue exophytic mass with hypodense areas. CCT shows enhancing mass with non-enhancing hypodense area representing central scar. Angiomyolipoma are commonly isolated sporadic tumors are associated with tuberous sclerosis. Sporadic AMLs without tuberous sclerosis are commonly detected in females during 5 to 7 decades. Is associated with neurofibromatosis 1, VHL or ADPKD. CT is generally the most accurate method because the presence of gross fat is characteristic of this lesion. The ROI of the lesion is typically less than 10 HU. This is a case of angiomyolipoma, hypodense lesion, minus 20 HU involving the cortex of left kidney showing minimal enhancement. Renal abscess is a collection of infective fluid in the kidney, sequelae of acute pyelonephritis, can affect any age, any gender, risk factors being diabetes mellitus, renal calculi. Most common signs are fever, flank pain, abdominal pain, chills, dysuria. CT is the most accurate method. An abscess appears as a well-defined mass of low attenuation with thick irregular wall or pseudocapsule, which can be better visualized on contrast and scans. If there is gas within the low attenuation cystic mass, then it strongly suggests abscess formation. This is CT of renal abscess. NACT shows isodense lesion in the midpole of right kidney with thickening of collecting system. Lesion shows peripheral enhancement with thickened enhancing cortical collecting system. The adjacent cortex shows decreased enhancement attenuation due to edema. Coming to last one, multilocular cystic nephroma. It is a distinct renal tumor of uncertain origin. It is a bulky, well encapsulated, non-infiltrating tumor with multiple non-communicating fluid-filled locules. It is predominantly evaluated in child because of a painless mass per abdomen, while in adult it presents as an abdominal pain and hematuria. Hematuria is often associated with herniation of tumor into the renal pelvis. Septa is usually thin with no enhancement. Usually the lesion has a thick capsule. Septal calcification is seen in about 10% of the cases. CT appearance. NECT shows a large multiseptated cystic lesion with thick calcified wall in the right kidney with no enhancement on contrast study. Coronal reformated image shows a clearly well-maintained fat plane around the lesion. This is a case of multilocular cystic nephroma. Summary, the study was done to show that the majority of renal masses were better detected, characterized and staged on multiphasic helical CT than other imaging modalities like intravenous pyelography, ultrasound or MRI. Thank you.